there is a huge concentration of media, there's a huge concentration of power, there is ample evidence that sometimes that power is misused. Not just, so there's a couple of things that you can talk about. One is the way news is gathered, nobody's necessarily saying that, but also the way news is deployed. I'm not saying that you should just let them roam free, okay? I'm not saying you shouldn't set up limits and expectations. Mm. What I'm saying is this particular proposal, which to be honest, I don't even think anyone's serious about, right, that you legally have some kind of a right, is just not the right way to go. Of course you want to develop a relationship with your children. You want them to trust you when they're younger. I have to really go with you here, that it's quite insulting to suggest that a perfectly normal, healthy, functioning man sees, searches out, is aroused by this kind of really fringe material, and then instantly turns into a sexual predator. I don't buy it. I think it's insulting, and I think.
But that's not the only.
So we must use technology to make sure that the politicians who support us hear from us, and that when the anti-choice want to do something that's anti-choice, they hear from us. They hear from pro-choice people. We yak and yak and yak. We never shut up. We say thank you. We say, what are you going to do about this? Believe me, our opponents never are quiet. Welcome everybody to Porn Wars. And the question, is there ever a case for pornography, or should it be off limits in an ethical society? Seems to be the arguments that are being made here is that what we've got is we've got this problematic industry and it's full of gonzo, and that's what's really selling well. And because this kind of garbage is going in, what's coming out, and this is really what the problem is, what's coming out is a really damaged male sexuality. Is it really that simple? Is it garbage in, garbage out? What I would contest is this idea that, you know, civilized societies have always had a respect for human life, and indeed they've always interpreted that kind of notion in the same way. In fact, where progressive societies are moving and where the central kind of ideas about ethics are now are really much more about autonomy. They're much more about recognizing that we live in a plural, diverse society. Your religious views are different to your views, which are different to your views, and that we all have a right to try to articulate for ourselves what we value, the way, what our needs are, and when we face something as critical as a terminal illness, what we choose to do about it. I woke up this morning bolt upright at 8:30 in the morning, having spent all day yesterday preparing this talk. And I thought, I'm saying the wrong thing. I've got the wrong topic. I'm coming here to speak about something that in fact these people do not want to hear, and it's not going to be very interesting to them. So instead, I've decided to say something completely different, which in the trade is known as flying by the seat of one's pants.
It's great to see you all here. With some trepidation, I grip the machine and try to take hold of the situation. But what I'm going to do is, if this for some reason does not work, I'm just going to put it down and I'm just going to go on. Okay, so I don't want anyone to panic. It's not the end of the world. I can do it without the slides.